Many years ago, there was a year that was a mighty bad year for witches. They were everywhere, big ones, little ones, and uglier ones. In fact, there were so many that there just weren't enough people to go around to cast spells upon.
Let go! I want to put him to sleep for 100 years!
You let go! I'm going to change him into a chicken!
But I saw him first!
You did not!
It got so bad that even the witches couldn't tell which witch was which. Then one day, as a little witch was searching the forest for a victim...
If I don't find somebody to cast a spell on pretty soon, I'll...
Then suddenly, the witch saw a little frog sitting on a log near a pond.
Well, what have we here?
We have a frog. What have we there?
I'm a witch.
That figures.
And I'm going to cast a spell on you.
Oh, come now. I'm already a frog. What else could you do to me?
But the witch was desperate, and with a wave of her hand, she changed the frog into a handsome young prince.
Oh, boy. That felt good.
Hey, what's the big idea? I don't want to be a handsome prince. I was happy as a frog.
Well, I admit it isn't the kind of a spell we usually cast, but times are hard. Ta-ta, dearie.
The young prince went back to the log and squatted down where he used to sit as a frog and dreamed of catching flies, but somehow it just wasn't the same. He even tried a few croaks.
Me. Chug-a-rump. A chug-a-rump!
But it was no use. He knew that if he was ever to be happy again, he must find the witch and make her change him back into a frog.
Well, it's like they say. You can take the frog out of the pond, but you can't take the pond out of the frog.
So the young man set off in search of the witch, and after several hours of stumbling through the woods, he stumbled into a castle. This particular castle was owned by a king who had a very beautiful but unmarried daughter.
Why don't you get a husband?
They're all frogs or something these days.
This young man who just walked through our wall doesn't look like a frog.
Oh, are you a handsome young prince?
No, I'm a handsome young frog.
See?
No. The boy is just a little mixed up. What he needs is a wife, say, like you.
So, despite the young prince's protests, they were married. They were very happy and had everything. Except a home.
But, dearest, do all brides have to live in a pond?
They do if their husband is a frog, and where are those flies I asked you to catch me?
But if I don't get a real house of my own pretty soon, I'll just die.
The young frog prince finally gave him a beautiful cottage. Then one day, when he was in the yard casing a June bug, a witch came by.
Oh, goody! A handsome young prince! Probably the last one left in the kingdom, and he's all mine! I'll change him into a frog? Good idea! A frog it will be.
That night, at the dinner table...
You know, honey, you've insisted that you're a frog for so long that you're even beginning to look like one.
But I keep telling you I am a frog, and if we don't move back to the pond, I'll just die.
Just then, the little witch who had originally cast a spell upon him came by and was amazed to see that he'd returned to a frog.
Mighty strange. Usually when I prince them, they stay princed. Well, I'll try again.
Only this time, he was changed into a chicken.
Well, that did it.
And deciding that it was time to call a halt to such nonsense, he angrily stormed into the witch's union where he confronted the head witch.
Now look, first I was a frog, then a prince, and now I'm a chicken. I've had enough King's X.
Okay, I'll change you back to whatever you say. What would you like to be?
Be a prince, honey.
Yeah, a prince.
So be it. Here, prince. Nice prince.
Not that kind of a prince.
Oh, sorry.
But tried, the old witch couldn't change him into a prince, so she finally returned him to a frog.
I'm sorry, dearie, but you've been bewitched so much that I just can't make a prince out of you.
The poor frog was confused and very sad. He turned to his wife and said,
Will you still love me even though I'm just a frog?
Well... Chug-a-rump! Yes.
And with that, they both hopped back to the pond where they sat on a mossy rock and exclaimed,
If we have to save frogs for the rest of our lives, we'll just die.
Of course, they didn't die, but you can rest assured that they croaked every night.